Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be letting you know what you shouldn't be doing with your site models. All right, so I've imported a few different projects from the 3D warehouse with different ways of dealing with topography. And I just want to describe why I don't think you should be using topography this way, or making your topography this way, or your slopes, if that's a better term for you. But what you can see here is that someone took a survey information or data they got from somewhere else that has topography, the topographic lines, and they just sort of like put it in and then extruded each of those up. And this is a great method for if you're physically modeling, because it's really hard to get slopes unless you're gonna like use clay or something like that. But in 3D, it's so much easier that you don't have to. And I think in this aspect, the topography is really distracting for me. I think, you know, the architecture is so neat that why have all this weird organic geometry going on? Why not just have the focus be on the building? So if your site is something like this, I do have lots of videos that talk about how to fix that, or how to model your contours, but I'm just gonna like really quickly show you how you can make some topography in SketchUp. So if you have something like this, I'm gonna delete those lines. So let's say we're gonna use the bottom of each of these. So here, okay, just double click this. Okay, so we just need to delete that guy. Okay, so I think that is pretty good. So I have the lines, I just need to delete this guy. Okay, so I have my my contours, and if you have a survey or something, these will come already. But basically, you just select those lines, go to Draw, Sandbox, and there's an option for contours or from contours, and SketchUp will generate the slope for you. Now, it's doing a little bit of weird things with the texture, but the topography itself is more true to what's in the real world, and it becomes less distracting versus this sort of step topography. The second thing that I've noticed is that a lot of models just have a flat land, and that's fine if it is generally flat, but in this particular instance, there's like this berm, and there's these sharp lines, and I think it's just misleading, and I think you can just soften those kind of things a little bit if it is mostly flat, and then there is this sort of berm. So what I would do is select these lines where the corners and things are. I'd use the round corner plugin by Frito. Here I have it set to 2 feet. So you just come in and then you hit enter. You can see that it softened all of that geometry. So now it is more accurate to what would be in the real world, because you don't have these straight angles when you are dealing with ground. So just a little tip to sort of bring more life to your 3D models. And then I've also seen a bunch of methods for people just making their own topography. This is triangulation, so this person may have just sort of like drawn a bunch of triangles to try to get what they were looking for. And this person made a grid, and then it looks like they started to move things up and down. And the method I'm going to show you, you can do this for either of these options, but I'm just going to do it once, just to simplify things a little bit, so you don't have to sit through this twice. But what we're going to do is, first I'm going to show you how to get rid of all these lines so you can sort of like smooth things out, because this doesn't really mean anything. It's useful for you if you're modeling, but if you're doing a presentation, these lines don't mean anything. Like a topography line makes sense because it means something. It's an increment. It's a level showing the verticality, but these aren't necessarily showing that. So first, if you have this sort of like triangulated mesh, as you want to come in, I'm just going to select all of this, go to my default tray. If you don't have that, you want to go to window default tray, and this will say show tray instead of hide tray. And then you also want to make sure soften edges is checked. So when you have that, then you can come over here to this little slider and you can use that. So you can see here that by using the slider, putting it at its max setting, it turns a lot of these lines to dashed lines, which means that they are hidden lines. But there are some lines that didn't quite go away. So what I'm going to do is hit E for the eraser tool and then hold down control and just mouse over each of these lines, and it's going to hide those lines. So this is already looking a lot better, but you can see there's some like weird, this looks like a low poly, which essentially it is. It looks like a low poly topography. And that's kind of distracting in some respects because the light's hitting it in weird ways. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to re-topology this. So I'm going to copy this off to the side. Come in here. I just want the topo here. Make this a component, and you should give it an actual name. For this, I'm not. So I'm going to come into this group. Actually, I don't need to do that just yet. I'm going to hit the R for rectangle tool. And I'm going to draw this rectangle. I hit the up arrow to lock it to the blue axis and then choose this opposite corner. And then just hit select all of that plane and then hit S for scale. Control to just make that a little bit bigger than the area that I am cutting, just to make sure that it cuts through everything. Make this a group. Hit M for move. Hit control to make a copy. Press the up arrow just to make sure that I'm locked to that blue axis. Hit 2 feet. You can see that in the bottom right corner. And then hit the asterisk symbol, 30. So now I have 30 little planes that are each 2 feet apart. Select everything. You can also hit control A. Actually, you can't because this stuff over here, it will be selected. So I'm just gonna select all this stuff. Right click, go to intersect faces with selection. So I have all that stuff. I'm just going to select these planes, and you can see that now I have a bunch of topography. There's a little bit of weirdness going on down here, so you can do that eraser tool again if you want to get rid of some of these lines. But I don't need that the thing that I had before, this thing. You don't necessarily need it. I'm gonna actually explode this so that I have one piece. So I have these edges basically. Go to select all with same material and go to delete. Now there may be a little bit of cleanup depending on how well your model was from the beginning. So I just had to delete that one line. Everything else looks okay. I'm just gonna select everything. Go to draw sandbox from contours like we did before. And you can see that I get a another box or another topography here. Now, the difference here is that this is a lot smoother than this, so you're not getting all those weird highlights and shadows that we were getting before. So, and because the building is here, that may or may not make a difference, depending on what you're doing. If you want to, you can always manually come in and delete some of this stuff. Come in here, I can always just delete. So I'm using the eraser tool and just getting rid of these interior little shapes, so they don't conflict with my model since I already have all that stuff. But if I turn hidden geometry off, you then have your topo lines. So it now has meaning because it's showing the verticality at 2 feet each. You can always turn that off if you want by hiding those edges. And you don't have all those weird highlights and shadows that are going on with this model. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers. Just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.